हेलो क्लास एट, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू विल बी फिट एंड फाइन. लेट्स डिस्कस चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ द बुक हनीड्यू. द चैप्टर इज विपिन चौधरीज लैप्स ऑफ मेमोरी. विपिन चौधरी इज द नेम ऑफ द कैरेक्टर एंड लैप्स यू नो मीन्स लॉस. Bipin Chaudhary's loss of memory. Something such happens in the story that Bipin Chaudhary that proves Bipin Chaudhary has lost his memory. How the incidents take place? Let's see. Before you read, you have a question. Do you have a good memory? Yes, everybody would say that he or she has good memory. Has your memory ever played any tricks on you? Now, this is the question. Has your memory ever played any tricks on you? Means, has such something ever happened with you that you forgot? Means that you had done, you had seen, but now you forgot. Any such trick? So here it is written, forgetfulness often puts you in a tight spot. Forgetfulness means when we forget certain things, then sometimes it is very shameful for us. It is very insulting for us, and we find ourselves in trouble sometime. Okay, means. Due to forgetfulness, we feel humiliated. So it is written, it puts you in a tight spot. But suppose forgetting a part of your life completely may drive you crazy. Suppose you have forgotten an incident or one part of your life which was very important and you have forgotten it. You put all efforts to memorize it, but it doesn't come to your mind. Then how would you feel? Of course, you will feel crazy. In this story, Bipin Babu goes nearly crazy because he cannot recollect his stay at Ranchi. So the story goes like this. You will see, Bipin Babu had once stayed at Ranchi and he cannot recollect about that stay at Ranchi. He puts all efforts, but that incident or that stay at Ranchi doesn't come to his mind, and he starts feeling crazy. He has never been to Ranchi, he thinks. He insists rather that I have never been to Ranchi, though there are many witnesses to the contrary. What is the suspense all about? Let's see. So there are many witnesses who will confirm that he had been at Ranchi. But he keeps on saying that he had never been to Ranchi. Now what was the suspense about? Let's see. Here is the story. Every Monday on his way back from work, Bipin Chaudhary would drop in at Kali Charan's in New Market to buy books, crime stories, ghost stories and thrillers. Every Monday when he used to come back from his office, Bipin Babu used to go to a shop, Kali Charan's shop, and it was in New Market. He used to go there to buy books. He used to purchase crime stories, ghost stories and thrillers. That thrill or sensations. He had to buy at least 5 at a time to last him through the week. Means he used to buy at least 5 books so that he could read them in the time or interval of a week. And then in the next week he would again come and would buy next 5. About him, he lived alone. He was not a good mixer, means he never mixed with other people. had few friends and did not like spending time in idle chat. Okay, idle chat, the text pages, they went down. Let's wait for 1 minute. Okay. So it was being told that he was not a good mixer. He had few friends and did not like spending time in idle chat. Idle chat being unnecessary talks, routine conversations. He did not involve himself in the idle chat. Today at Kali Charan's, Bipin Babu had the feeling that someone was observing him from close quarters. Close quarters mean from very much near. After him, someone was there who was looking at him, who was observing him. He felt it. He turned round and found himself looking at a round-faced, meek-looking man who now broke into a smile. Then he turned around and he saw that there was a man who had round face, who was meek looking, mean who looked very humble. And when he looked at him, that man started smiling. Okay. And he said, "I don't suppose you recognize me." That man said, "Sir, I think you didn't recognize me. Have we met before? Asked Bipin Babu. Bipin Babu asked him, "Have we met earlier too?" The man looked greatly surprised. He was very shocked, very surprised to listen this. He said, "We met every day for a whole week. Sir, we had met every day for 1 week. I arranged for a car to take you to Hudru Falls. Once you had been in Ranchi, and at that time you had to go to Hudru Falls, and I had arranged a car for you." You can see here in the picture, this is the picture of the bookshop. There is a bookseller and this is Bipin Babu. And this is another man, round-faced man, very meek and talking about this man, Bipin Babu, that he knows him and Bipin Babu perhaps has forgotten him. He says, "I had arranged a car for you because you had to go to Hudru Falls in 1958. I had done so. In Ranchi, I had done so. And my name is Parimal Ghosh." He announced, he declared his name. So he is Parimal Ghosh. Now, Bipin Babu realized that it was not he, but this man who was making a mistake. Earlier, Bipin Babu thought that I might be making a mistake to recognize him. He might be knowing me. But now he felt that this man is making a mistake to recognize me. Bipin Babu had never been to Ranchi. He had been at the point of going several times. Yes. Bipin Babu knows that he had never been to Ranchi, had never gone to Ranchi. He had been at point of going several times but never made it. He had planned many times to go to Ranchi but he could never go there. He smiled and said, "Do you know me? Do you know who I am?" Then that man started smiling. Bipin Babu started smiling and said, "Do you know who I am? Do you know my name?" The man raised his eyebrows, bit his tongue and said, Do I know you? Who doesn't know Bipin Chaudhary?" So the man raised his eyebrows, started biting his tongue, bite, bit, bitten. This is second form, bit. B-I-T-E, bite, B-I-T, bit, B-I-T-T-E, and bitten. Bit his tongue and said, "Do I know you? What are you saying, sir? I know you. Who doesn't know Bipin Chaudhary?" Now he told his name. He told him his name. Bipin Babu now turned towards the bookshelves and said, "Still you are making a mistake. One often does. I have never been to Ranchi. Then he said, sir, still you are making a mistake. Okay, you might be knowing my name, but it may be someone else. I am not the fellow whom you are recognizing because I had never been to Ranchi. The man now laughed aloud. The man started laughing loudly. But are you saying, Mr. Chaudhary, you had a fall in Hudru and cut your right knee? I brought you iodine. I had fixed up a car for you to go to Netrahat the next day, but you could not because of pain in the knee. Can't you recall anything? Now the man narrated an incident at Ranchi. He says, sir, what are you saying? You didn't know me? Have you forgotten that when you had been to Hudru Falls, then you had a fall there, meaning you had fallen there and you have got a cut on your right knee. And I had arranged iodine for you. And again I had fixed up a car, arranged a car for you to go to Netrahat next day. But you were not in the condition to go there due to the pain in your knee. Can't you recall anything? Can't you remember anything? Then he adds something else. Says, someone else, you know, was also in Ranchi at that time. At that time, someone else was also with you. Mr. Dinesh Mukherjee. You stayed in a bungalow. Bungalow. Just see the spelling. B-U-N-G-A. Bungalow. L-O-W. Bungalow. Bangalore. Bungalow. You stayed in a bungalow. You said you didn't like hotel food and would prefer to have your meals cooked by a Bavarchi. So, you didn't stay in any hotel, you stayed in a bungalow and it was your excuse that you didn't like hotel food, you like food cooked by a cook in home, Bavarchi. Mr. Mukherjee stayed with his sister. You had a big argument about the moon landing. Mr. Mukherjee was also staying with you and he had been staying with his sister, and you often had some debates or arguments, and you had a very big argument about the moon landing, remember? He was adding certain incidents and talks, important things which could help Bipin Babu recollect his visit to Ranchi. I will tell you more. You always carried a bag with your books in it on your sightseeing trips. Am I right or not? Then Parimal Ghosh said, sir, whenever you used to go out for some trip, sightseeing trips, you always carried a bag with your books. Am I right or not? Now, Bipin Babu spoke quietly. He said his eyes still on the books. He was looking at the books and he said something very quietly in a very low tone. Which month in 58 are you talking about? He asked. In 58, which month? The man said, October. Bipin Babu said, no, sir, said Bipin Babu. I spent puja in 58 with a friend in Kanpur. You are making a mistake. Good day. So he said, no sir, you are wrong. In that year, I had been doing puja with one of my friends in Kanpur. It's your mistake. Now good day. You are disturbing me. But the man did not go, nor did he stop talking. Now this man was not ready to go and he was not ready to stop talking. He just wanted Bipin to recollect his visit to Ranchi. He adds other details also. Very strange. Sir, one evening I had a tea with you in a veranda of your bungalow. Have you forgotten that? One evening I had come to you to have tea in the veranda of your bungalow. Veranda means Brahmadas, dear students. You spoke about your family. At that time you have told me about your family also. You said you had no children and that you had lost your wife 10 years ago. Your only brother had died insane, which is why you didn't want to visit the mental hospital in Ranchi. So these were certain personal details about Mr. Bipin. He added that, and he told that these things, these personal details were provided to him by Bipin Chaudhary himself. But were those that Bipin had no children, that his wife had died 10 years ago, and he had only brother who died insane, means he had got mad. Okay, so he died. That is why he didn't ever like to visit mental hospital in Ranchi. When Bipin Babu had paid for the books and was leaving the shop, the man still looking at him in utter disbelief. So Bipin Babu listened to all the details and did not reply anything. He just paid for the books he had purchased, and then he left the shop. And that man, Parimal Ghosh, he was still looking at him in utter disbelief, mean in complete surprise. What was the utter disbelief? That this man, Mr. Bipin, was not recognizing him, and he could not recollect anything about his visit to Ranchi. So this is the first question you see in the comprehension check part 1. Why did the man stare at Bipin Babu in disbelief? Because Bipin Babu could not recollect anything about his visit to Ranchi, and Bipin Babu was also not recognizing Parimal Ghosh. Where did Bipin Babu say he went in October 58? He told that he had been doing puja with one of his friends in Kanpur. Mention any three more things that Parimal Ghosh knew about Bipin Babu. These three things, dear children, will be his personal details, like he had no children, his wife had died 10 years ago, and his brother had died insane. These are the other important things about Bipin Babu which were known to Parimal Ghosh. So I think we should stay here for today. Actually, dear children, there are 4 parts of this chapter, and I will be taking them in each video. And till then, what you have to do? You have to read this first part of this chapter, and if you find any problem, if you find any word difficult for you, any sentence you could not understand, then you may make a call to me. You can drop a message to me, and you have to write the answers to these 3 questions also in your notebook. Okay, so keep doing your work, stay happy, stay healthy, stay indoors, and take care of health. Okay, thank you very much.